All right, this is Dinner Date.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to Dinner Date with David, Crystal, and Christian. Have a seat, sit down, and grab a glass of wine.
Yeah, we're going to have an in-depth discussion. This week's topic is, what is your deepest, darkest secret?
That makes David giggle. It's very exciting.
It's the voice, I think.
So the thing about Crystal is earlier she said she had a deep, dark secret about a kitty, and if we knew a kitten, and if we knew about it, we would think worse of her. We wouldn't want to be her friend. We wouldn't want to be around her. We'd look at her strangely, but she won't tell what it is.
What is it?
I didn't say it was a deep, dark secret. I just said I wouldn't tell you what it was.
That is a deep, that's the definition of a deep, dark secret, something you do not want other people to know.
Well, maybe I just specifically don't want you guys to know.
Is it slang?
But we want to know what's your deep, dark secret? Come on, Crystal, when you say that in front of people, that's all they want to know, though, is what you did to a kitten that we would look at you differently in.
Right.
I often do that when I come out of a bathroom. I go, you don't want to know what I mean. In fact, I won't tell you. No, tell us. Tell us. It's dinner, guys. Come on. Tell us.
Please tell us. Fine. All right, Christian, you have to do your secret then.
Well, the thing is, you make Christian do his secret, the thing is, from experience, I have learned that David will try and get everyone else to say stuff, and then
he will renege.
He'll be like, "Oh, my deepest darkest secret I ate a candy bar for lunch." Yeah.
My deepest darkest secret is I don't like your guys' deepest darkest secret.
You're making people feel bad. There's three of us sitting here. It's Crystal, Christian, and me, David.
Right.
And now you're making all of our listening audience feel badly about me that I'm some kind of renegger. That's a word. It's that I don't do what I'm supposed to do.
Take it back.
All right, this is why we settle it. 1, 2, 3. Not it.
Not it.
All right, Christian has to give his secret first.
Wait, can we do? Can we
if
do?
If only it weren't for alcohol.
1, 2, 3. Not it.
Paired. Not it.
Christian, you lost twice. You have to do it.
Can we do rock? I have a buzz.
No, you have to do. What's your deepest darkest secret?
We're gonna
get it.
We're gonna do.
I have a deep dark secret, and I will reveal it. But I go last.
You know what?
We're gonna do. Okay.
1, 2, 3. Not it.
Not it.
I just have to.
I have to do it.
Okay.
I'm drinking the.
Even though I didn't lose, I think that we live in a democratic society, and therefore we should vote. Who thinks David should go first?
You guys
raise your hand.
Not it.
Not it.
I second that motion.
You guys suck.
Okay.
It's horrible though, and you will think worse. All right.
Okay.
I'll only tell it under one condition.
What's that?
Crystal is the girl here, and we think highly of her, and we're a little bit afraid of her. Christian, wouldn't you agree?
Absolutely.
If you promise that you won't feel weird about me, you'll still love me.
Okay.
You'll still respect me. I mean to say it though.
Okay.
Say it right now.
Oh yeah, I will. I'll still love and respect you in the morning.
Okay. It's really. I'm starting to blush a little bit.
Really?
Okay. Well, it makes me look real bad. I come off looking real bad in this.
I think that's the point. That's the point of the deepest darkest secret.
If it's a deep dark secret, and it doesn't make you look bad, we wonder why you keep it a secret.
Yeah.
Because this is the thing too. This is why I don't want to tell it, because people think she already said that she thinks that I'm one of those people that won't, like, I'm the kid that won't play. Like, haha, you have to do it and I won't do it.
Now people
feel really bad at me and I tell the secret and they're going to feel really horrible.
I just
about
said
me.
From past experience, you have gotten us to reveal such things as, I don't know, deep dark secrets.
You got and me then, to take my top off.
And then you won't reciprocate, is all.
All right, this is the thing. Okay, you gotta take yourself to that place where you hate somebody.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay,
I'm picturing you.
I'm picturing Andy McDowell.
Okay, this is what it is. Now that I think about it, I just kind of set it in my head and it doesn't feel that bad. But, okay, I hated somebody. All right? Okay. I hated somebody a lot.
Right, for sure.
To the core of my being. Mm-hmm. And I wished them ill.
Uh-huh.
And the ill I wished on them happened to them.
Right.
And
I was going to say
so
malaria.
You're telekinetic? I don't understand.
Well, no. I mean, I don't know. For a second, I thought so because it was so specific and
you
the specific thing happened
to
them.
And then it happened.
Yeah, and it happened to them.
Was it that kid in the wheelchair again?
No. This happened recently.
Oh.
Uh-huh. It was a friend that I had that I hated and I wished cancer on him and he got it. And it's horrible. Like he lost 50 pounds and
So he looked good. He looked real good. Like cancer good. Like skinny.
No, that's if girls lose 50 pounds and they're
wow, really?
Skinny.
That's where this went.
I don't know.
Well, I hated him and now I don't hate him so much anymore, even though he's kind
because
of
he got cancer?
because I gave him cancer.
Yeah.
I don't think he gave it to him.
No, but come on. This is the thing. I was like, I hope he gets cancer. And then he gets cancer. Like, me saying those exact words actually to another person, wouldn't you think feel weird if that happens?
I would feel weird if that happens. But you know what? I honestly, I mean, I know you, and I think that you got mad and you said it, like, out of anger, and probably you said it in some sort of flippant way where you thought, well, he's not really going to get cancer. Like, you probably thought that if you had said, oh, I hope he gets hit by a bus, the chances of that happening were more likely, and then you would feel really badly. But you sort of just said it because you thought, oh, it will never actually happen, so I'm just saying it to be mean, kind of a thing.
He got hit by a bus named
Thank
cancer.
Thank you for thinking the better.
Yeah.
It's true.
The thing that makes it so badly is that I've seen him recently, and he's kind of wasting away, and that's what's like, oh, my God, that's horrible.
Yeah.
I shouldn't be laughing, but it's funny how we rationalize the way cancer being wished upon someone else.
So now
I can understand you. What? I don't hate you in any way, shape, or form.
Do you guys respect me still?
I respect you for all your admirable qualities, David, and your,
like what?
And your cancer wishing. Can I name the same one over and over again?
Yes, name it three times.
All right, forget it. Who cares? Let's go to your guys' deep, dark secrets. What's yours, Crystal? Ready, kitten, go.
We had a cat, and she had 3 kittens. Mm-hmm. One of them – oh, no, sorry. She had 4. Okay. One of them was a stillborn. Ooh. The other one she slept on and suffocated.
Oh, my God.
The other two survived. Now, two out
survived motherhood.
Exactly. She was a stray, and she probably had many kittens over her life. So kittens were like pennies on the road to her, you know. But she wasn't a good mother, but she had cute kittens anyway. So I can't remember if it was the stillborn or the one that she suffocated.
I think
it was the stillborn.
I don't like where this is going.
We had to had to clean up the kittens, right?
Uh-huh.
We had to dispose of it.
Put
so,
it in a coffin, little tiny
I put
suit.
It in a
Crystal has a smile on her face. I don't know if you've noticed that she's telling this. Go.
I think she's a little nervous. You have a big smile on your face, too.
Yeah.
Because I'm freaking out. Go.
Okay. So I got a plastic bag, but like it was like one of the clear, you know. Produce. Not the Ziplocs.
Gotcha.
Like you get apples in or something.
Right. Yeah.
And I picked up the kitten in the bag.
You can't suffocate it again.
And then have you ever taken a bag, you know, and you put the 2 ends on your finger and
you
twirl it around?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, I kind of did that with the kitten.
Oh, my goodness.
That's it?
Did
it fly up? And
No, it didn't fly up, but
in
I was like, I mean, there were other people around. It wasn't like all by myself. My mom was there and I was like.
You made a plaything?
Did it splatter on people or?
Oh, my God.
I thought it was going to be
much
worse.
I thought
it was going to be like kitty porn or like kitty snuff film or something like that.
Essentially, it is. It's like a recollection.
No, the cat was already did you videotape it?
No, I didn't videotape it.
It could have been.
Oh, mine is so much worse than yours. I thought Crystal was going to look like a bad person. Oh, Crystal.
Well, Christian apparently thinks that. See, look,
That's pretty rough.
Who do you think is the worst person, me or Crystal? Me or Crystal?
Well, due to your finger pointing at Crystal, I'd have to say, David.
So. Yes!
Damn it!
Yeah.
All right, deepest, darkest secret ready? Go, Christian.
All right. Back when I was, I used to be a kind of a goody-two-shoes kid. Like, I'd always go to school and stuff like that. I don't know why he's laughing.
I don't know either.
I didn't say goody-tushy or anything like that. I don't know what you're thinking
goody
about.
Goody-poo-poo?
I don't know. Go.
Yeah, I was just kind of a goody-giddy little brat, little snot-nosed. You know, whatever. I was too afraid to do anything like that. I would always just go home after school and, you know.
Well, you're a self-proclaimed nerd, though. I mean,
would you call me?
You are a self-proclaimed nerd. You've already said that a million times.
Yeah. But that's kind of redundant. Self-proclaimed nerd. You've already said that. Okay. So, I ended up meeting a friend who was in a grade above me when I was going to a public school. I'd gone to private schools most of my life. So, you know, wore a uniform. Like, wonderful. So... He was a friend of mine, and he was a little out there. He was, like, really, like, a little bit out there. So one day we were just walking home from school, and we had to walk through a graveyard to get to my house. So we're walking through the graveyard, and I forget if it was him or me, but one of us trips over a minuscule gravestone. I mean, it's got to be 1 foot by 1 foot high, and it's maybe about 2 inches thick. Boom, thing claps over, just falls over, slap on the ground.
Tombstone.
Yeah, but it was small. It was like one of those small ones, and it actually just went slap, and it fell over. For whatever reason, we thought this was the funniest thing on earth, because we were just talking.
How old
were
you?
10?
10? Okay.
10 years old. Yeah. So we just start cackling, like, this is the funniest thing on earth, and the only thing that could make it more funny is if we
knocked down more.
So we proceeded, and this is right after school got out, so it's about 3:30 in the afternoon. We start knocking over gravestones. You know, first it starts like a little bit bigger stuff. We can just push over at once. We then start rocking over like 4 and 5 foot, 4 and 5 foot high ones. We have
you
to rock them.
You can push over tombstones? I thought they were cemented in there.
Most of the time not. And especially
really?
The old ones.
I've never tried to
old ones
over,
can be pushed
huh?
over. David's apparently attempted this.
No, I never have. I just figured that they were.
We carry lathes on us at all times so we can just grind it down and just. We were
it's
in shock.
We're doing LARPing.
Yeah. Oh.
Wait, you don't.
Oh, no.
Or anything about this. You well, seem proud.
I actually am feeling kind of nervous
proud.
Nervous
seems,
right now. I just
oh,
kind
are?
Of steeled myself.
Ashamed.
I steeled myself with the assistance of Corona. To,
Le Corona.
Okay, so
we start knocking over these gravestones. Broad daylight. It's about 3:30. School just got out. It's insane. I don't even know why. It's like one of those blackout periods of my life. I remember it all, but it's like, oh no, I was being operated by a robot at the time, officer, so I couldn't have been responsible. So we ended up knocking over about 20 or so.
Wow.
I mean, like, and some of them were big, taller than us. Like, we had to rock them back and forth to get them over.
Wow.
And it's like one of those things where I can't even believe I did it. So, of course, three cop cars show up. They all roll up on the path, block the paths. They get out of the cars and tell us to lie on the ground, everything like that.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. And I'm at this point, I'm freaking out. So they
did you wet yourself? Is that
the no. Well, I did in a way. So I... They,
spiritually.
Right. I was spiritually incontinent.
His
but
aura
they,
oozed.
Yeah. So the cops come out, give us a talking to, really start talking to, find out where we live, and everything like that. And then we have to go around and pick up all the gravestones.
Oh, that's good.
Which was good, but we couldn't lift half of them, even with the cops' help. We couldn't lift them up because there were hundreds and hundreds of pounds. We couldn't
wow.
lift them up. They were big. Like, one of them was like a statue. We knocked. I mean, I was 10 years old. He was like 11 or 12, and I couldn't even believe that. So, you know, it's one of those experiences where you can't, like, feel your legs. You're numb. You don't know what the hell's going to happen. You're like, oh, my parents. Like, realize I've been goody two-shoes, like, my entire life, mm-hmm. and now this is, like, tantamount to me, you know, I don't know, suffocating a kitten and putting him in a bag and twirling him or something. Like that. It was, like, horrible. Your story's over, Crystal. It's my turn. So,
Crystal, but, I think that does for death too much.
So
how did they get them up then? How did they get?
They didn't. We just left them there.
Even the cops
did? So still to this day, or probably that, yeah, we couldn't lift them. There was no way. So there are still gravestones that on mine and my friend's behalf are knocked over. Someone's dead family member. Has had their gravestone defaced.
I know. Do you realize how horrible the family feels when they come to see that tombstone? They take it as a sign, like, ah!
Oh my God. Yeah, he died, or some 10-year-olds just ran through. And you know.
No, they don't think that. They think horrible thoughts. See, that's why I want my tombstone to be concrete cemented in.
Yeah, some of these might have been. I don't know. But I mean,
you guys
realize,
are that strong.
You realize nowadays, had we had like M80s on us, we would have
right.
just.
Like most
know.
Kids.
Oh,
like
totally.
Most
like,
kids are
most
horrible 10 people.
To 12
kids are horrible people until
see,
they become
what
older.
You did was not that horrible because once you do it, you think, oh my God, this is out of control. Like, I had the urge to do it as you were telling the story. Like, wow, I want to go to a graveyard and knock over tombstones for sure.
Wow.
But you feel repentance. Obviously, it's not a deep, dark secret unless you feel repentance. If you still feel good about it, it doesn't matter. You obviously
right.
feel yeah. that there's something wrong with it. Like your story, you felt there was something wrong with it, and now you feel bad about it, but you
all
like
right,
you
can
should
I tell you the
you,
worst part of my deepest, darkest secret.
You injected yeah. cancer into someone's face, like you verbally.
Not his
injected.
Face in his body.
Well,
I want to hear the worst part.
Is that I kind of felt?
Oh no.
Good.
No.
When
no.
I found out that I kind of felt like wow, like
no.
You know what? No. You know what I felt? I felt like wow, karma works.
Oh yeah, it does.
The guy's a shithead. The guy. Because
that's not going to come back on you. That's not going to come back on you or anything. Because
wow.
karma isn't a bitch or anything, David.
Karma might be my friend, though. Karma might like be like.
Karma
oh,
might
you know
be
what.
A friend for wishing cancer upon somebody.
Yeah. You ever wonder why nature made you bald? You think it just might be preparing you for chemotherapy?
I think you might want to watch My Name is Earl.
Look at my face. What more can karma do to me? Look at me. Look at my skin's practically. Anyways.
Do you want to know what karma could do to you?
I
keep on going. Keep wishing cancer upon people.
Yeah.
Karma
oh,
will
no.
show you. It will show you.
Oh, no.
You should read the picture of Dorian Gray and watch My Name is
I
Earl.
I did read
both
picture of Dorian
things.
Gray. I cannot watch Jason Lee, though. I cannot
right,
watch
we are,
him.
We are taking a super
at least
here.
Read the synopsis and figure out what it's about.
So that, okay. I think that just about wraps up our segment. On,
wow, we all come in with really yeah. good deep
I feel
secrets.
Bad. I feel like I need another beer and a loaded weapon right now. I like really.
I think that,
so you could shoot David before you use
oh,
the cancer?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think that Crystal's a better person than both you and I because hers is so, like, nothing. Hers is so, like, that's what she feels badly about. Like, you know what I mean?
Sort of.
I mean, like the smaller things.
Christian's
you feel
totally
the worst
creeped
about.
Out, and he thinks I'm a disturbed, deranged person.
I really do.
Yeah. But it was dead, though.
Oh, God. That's great. That covers all manner of sins, right?
She wasn't touching
you
it.
You raped a corpse, but it was
oh,
dead,
you're
though.
Right. That's probably masking deeper, darker secrets that she has by saying, oh, it's dead.
No.
All right.
But I think it just creeps Christian out.
Yeah,
it
absolutely.
Does kind of creep me out a little, but
this whole thing creeps me out. I
but
feel uncomfortable.
He is really into
well. Then
cats,
let's
though.
End the segment.
Yeah. I love Le that
segment.
Get her done.
Alrighty,
all
guys.
Right.
Well, I think that wraps up our deepest, darkest secrets Le on secret dinner date. That was definitely not something we would share at like a normal dinner party or anything like that.
No, for
I think
sure.
We've gone over.
Yeah, we have gone over. All right, guys. Well, thanks for listening to Dinner Date with David, Crystal, and Christian.
Okay, welcome.
So intro, people. Come on.
Dinner Date. Welcome.
Oh my goodness. Hi, wait, this is Dinner Date. Welcome to Dinner Date.
Hi. Hey,
my
everybody, it's Dinner Date.
Slackers.
Hey, everybody, it's Dinner Date. Have a seat with Crystal, Christian, and David. Sit down, kick up your feet, grab a glass of wine. And,
wow.
Looks like
we have
another visitor.
Right the,
looks
right
like we have
back.
Another
we have
visitor.
A call, yep.
Someone's phoning in to dinner.
So let's see. I can get this right because I am. Here we go. Hello.
Hello, caller. Who is this? We have a caller on the line.
Yeah, this is Noni calling from Koreatown.
Oh, hi, Noni.
Hi,
Koreatown.
Noni.
Wow.
Noni from Koreatown.
How's the
excellent.
Food?
It's pretty, well, I'm not eating right now, but it's generally pretty good.
Excellent.
That's
excellent.
Good.
How old are you, Noni, from Koreatown?
26.
26? Oh, 26. I heard 6.
So it's Noni, 26, from Koreatown, and you have a problem that you're calling us about?
Right. My problem is there's this guy that I've known for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
We were friends. Well, we are friends.
Mm-hmm.
And he moved away.
Okay.
Like, probably a couple years ago, and we, like, fell out of touch, right?
Sure.
And then he found me on MySpace and sent me, like, a...
MySpace?
Yeah. Yeah.
And I was like, okay, sure, yeah, whatever. Hey, what's up? And then he, one day, like months later, he asked me for my number. So anyways, I'm going to speed this up. I'm sorry.
That's all right. That's all right. We've got plenty of time.
So he called me, and then we talked for like, I don't know, it was like an hour or something, and it was really random. And then
kind of like right now.
Out of nowhere, he was like, you know, I really like you or whatever. And I was like, excuse me?
What?
And then he just like... said that he liked me for a long time, and he, like,
okay.
has been thinking about it, and I was like,
clearly.
Okay, well, you live in another state, dude. Like, what are you trying to accomplish here?
Right.
Anyway, so then we started talking. He started calling me every day.
Mm-hmm.
We were talking for, like, hours, and I was like, and he said, like, right off the bat, long-distance relationships don't work, and I was like, I am not the one calling you. You're calling me, and I'm not interested in having a long-distance relationship.
Oh, hell
so
yeah.
He was like...
Okay.
Yeah.
So then one night we were talking.
Mhm.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me that he loves me.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
He loved you long time?
I didn't know what to say. Like, I just kind of like was like, "All right." Like, I don't know. how can you say that? That you love me. Like, we're not even in a relationship.
Right, absolutely.
He has no right to love you
if you're not in a relationship. No right at all.
Now, wait, is he in the state where you're in yet or no?
No.
Oh, okay, so what's your problem exactly?
Well, I take it you don't love him, right?
What?
I take it you don't love him, right?
Quit putting words in her mouth.
Well, why would it be a problem if she loved him?
Well, let's hear her.
Okay.
Let's hear your exact problem. Ready? Go.
Okay, the problem is that he tells me he likes me, he tells me he misses me, and then he'll tell me about all these girls he's screwing.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Nice.
Wow. that was a curveball out of left field.
Well, have you asked him, does he mate with these women in lieu of your company?
Mate?
Does he picture you while he's sleeping with them?
Does he have a paper bag with your face on it?
No. Well, I don't.
Yeah, you haven't asked that question, yeah. Have you?
If you can't be with the one you love, right?
So,
that well.
Okay, just it doesn't matter. It's funnier when you can't understand what they're saying. So wait a minute. So your problem is what though? Like, do you want to have a relationship with him, or is he just some?
Thing. He called me recently. Well, he stopped calling me for for a while after I kind of was like, dude, we can't keep doing this. This is, like, weird.
For sure.
So he didn't call me for a while, and then recently he started calling me again, and then he told me he missed me a lot, and then he told me he's moving here.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Wow. So do you like him? Do you want to have a relationship with him? Is that the thing?
Well, he was all like, oh, I'm going to fucking hit that when I come out there.
Oh, that's nice.
Sounds like a real romantic. I like that.
Yeah.
Take you out to a nice lobster dinner.
I'm not a fucking booty call, dude. Like, if you plan on hitting anything, you better plan on having a fucking relationship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're taking me to Red Lobster, bitch.
If you want
to
hit this,
I better get some Sizzler. Okay.
Or you're going to hit the bricks.
Okay. Well, I told him, I was like, we can, like, if you want to ask me out on a date, you can ask me out on a date, but I'm, like, we've been friends for a long time, so it's hard to get mad at him.
Right.
But I know him, you know what I mean?
Right.
Right.
So wait, I don't understand what your problem is, or did you just want
to... Yeah, you just wanted to share?
Did you just want to call up and chat with us?
That? Like, how can he say he loves me and he wants to whatever, but then at the same time, oh, I banged this really hot chick the other day, or, oh, I met this girl at this bar and she, like, gave me, like, the best blowjob ever. And I'm like, okay, why do I want to hear this? And why would you fucking... And then he'll apologize.
He sounds like...
I'm like, wow, that's awesome. And then he'll be like, oh, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. And I'm like, what? Like, should I just, like, stop talking to him? Or?
Well, yeah, he sounds like a pro wrestler.
He's a fucking idiot or what?
I think it sounds like he's really comfortable with you. And I think it's, in a way, it's kind of a good sign that he's willing to tell you anything, even though he thinks it might, he probably knows it's probably turning you off a little bit of having a relationship with him. But he's still willing to tell you. I think it's a good sign that if you were to have a relationship with him, he would actually be open and honest with you.
Although, counterpoint, crazy people will often say the most absurd things to you, thinking, oh, what's the big deal? So I slept with this girl, this random girl, but I love you. Like, crazy people will offer up that kind of stuff.
But
so.
He apologized for telling her.
David?
That's true. Crazy people won't apologize. What?
That's true.
What?
From experience?
Yeah, I'm speaking from experience.
Yeah, this is part of David's playbook.
That's how David's mom explained his birth.
Oh, my. I did.
I don't get it.
My.
Well, this is the thing. Most girls, I don't understand why you're not doing this. Most girls, when you tell them, most girls I talk to when I say I love you and then I talk about other chicks I bang, they're like, you're disgusting. Don't tell me that stuff and don't call me that click and they hang up.
Yeah.
No, but
I already told them. I was like, I know. I mean, you. I don't know why you keep saying we're not going to be in a long distance relationship because I'm not even interested and I haven't even asked you. You're the one who said you love me. But then,
oh my
like,
God.
He keeps bringing it up.
Oh, Crystal knows. She's got the
issue. I know what
issue.
He's doing.
Ready? Go.
Okay, he's trying to brag about all these girls he's been with to make himself seem more attractive.
Yeah.
See, look, all these other women want to get with me. Don't you want to get with me?
Well, I told him, I was like, dude, you're such a fucking slut. And he's like, why are you out?
All right, we had to bleep you out there. We had to drop you there.
Yeah, we had to bleep the
One more outburst like that, and we'll have to hang up on you. I'm sorry, FCC.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is this, like, for radio?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you called a radio show, but okay.
Sorry, this is not the suicide hotline.
Oh, you thought we were just chatting? Like, oh, hi.
Definitely not the suicide.
It was one of those explicit podcasts.
We don't have one of those constant dinners happening all the time.
Yeah, we're not in Europe. What do you think you are? Okay, watch your language, bitch.
I talked to Garvin that just said that?
No, what? All right, we're going to have to let you go, caller.
No, wait, what? we've got a little bit more to add
on
that.
Yeah, we have more time on this.
Oh, wait, Crystal wants to go off on you. Ready? Go.
I don't want
to
go off on
you. No, what I wanted to say, though, I kind of have to agree with Crystal. I think this person has the, short man's disease where he's got to constantly compensate, and show that he's, more of a man,
right.
Which equates to number of blowjobs received. So... But he obviously shows that he cares and he opens up and probably feels a little bit sensitive, saying that stuff. But I think David is also right in the fact where women should just react like, oh, my God, are you actually telling me this? This is disgusting. I'm going to go shop and hang up on him.
Yeah, in my era, women would act like, you can't talk to me like that. I'm a lady. Like, they would demand respect.
Though, I think...
Everyone knows guys who are single, like, go and they hook up. Like, fine. Like, I know that.
What? See, you're from that generation of, like, guys are going to do whatever they're going to do, and I guess I have to live with it.
I think in some ways, you can make it clear to him that you don't want to really hear too much detail about these other girls and stuff. But in some ways, I wouldn't want to cut the communication he's giving you. I mean, you'd basically be chopping him down and saying, well, this is an area we can't talk about. So I don't know that I would go and say, oh, don't, totally freak out on him. I would maybe make it...
he has said, like, oh, well, like, you're, like, someone I can really talk to about, like, everything. And I'm like, okay, so, like, there's that.
Right.
But I don't want to be like, oh, well, you can't talk to me anymore.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, when he gets out here, just let him hit that and see what happens after that. Yeah. That's what I say.
Yeah, high five.
Let him hit it. Let him hit it hard. But, yeah. Girl, make him take you to the Red Lobster beforehand, mm-hmm. Okay?
And if he goes and tells you about women he slept with since, you know, once he moves here, then forget it. But if he's all about you once he gets here, then see where it goes.
Yeah, and when you're at Red Lobster, order the white wine, because then you know, he knows that you're expensive, that you expect something.
That you're a bitch who rolls right, okay?
The steak and lobster right. Dinner. The combo.
All right, Noni.
We're going to have to let you
go, gotta let
Noni,
you go.
From 26 from wherever you are is. Okay, goodbye, Noni.
Bye, Noni.
Bye, Noni. Thanks for calling.
Wow. I want to log on right now.
Here's Christian with the Wow Report. Okay, this is a special edition of WoW. This is a CTFO edition of WoW Report. Okay,
so that's called the F out for anyone.
Yeah. Christian, I want you to read this sentence right here. Okay, this is a quote from Vint Cerf, Vint Cerf is the father of the internet. He is the man credited with inventing
the
internet.
I thought it was
Al Gore.
No.
He also has four letters.
Al Gore's full of S.
He also has four letters in his first
name
and four letters in his last name.
Here, I want you to read this quote right there, starting at the arrow. Ready,
Vint Cerf. It's V-I-N-T-C-E-R-F. Four-letter first name, four-letter last name. All right.
Vint, that's a great name.
So
sort of reminds me of Zinfandel or something.
This is actually, do you know what this is from? This is from Esquire, where David gets most of his knowledge from. It may seem like some sort of waste of time to play World of Warcraft with your son, but you're actually interacting with each other. You're solving problems. They may seem like simple problems, but you're solving them. You're posed with challenges that you have to overcome. You're on a quest to gain certain capabilities. I haven't spent a lot of time playing World of Warcraft because my impression is that it takes a serious amount of time to play it well.
Hell yeah.
This guy's obviously a noob. I mean.
So, this is the father. This is a well-lauded man, you know, telling us the riches of World of Warcraft. Play it with your son. Play World of Warcraft with your son. So, I want to know, Christian. I want your reaction.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, I have to discount anything he said. He really hasn't put enough time into the game for me to respect any of his opinions.
But
he obviously spent enough time having sex with women and rearing children above World of Warcraft, which is really, you know, if you've actually spent any time in the online community, you know, in World of Warcraft, you're pretty much hazed and ridiculed for
that. In his defense, if he has a teenage son he procreated before World of Warcraft, he wasted his time sleeping with his wife way before World of Warcraft was founded.
When there was nothing else to do.
Yeah, I mean, what else was he supposed to do? Log on to a BBS? I mean, really?
Really?
Well,
yeah. So, Christian, what do you have to say now?
Crystal called it, though. Log on to a BBS. Come on. I mean, I'm saying there's stuff out there.
Yes,
what's a BBS?
A bulletin board service. It was the online internet chat rooms and the ways you could get software and things like that before the intranet.
Oh, that's what he created.
Probably. So he probably had the opportunity.
So, though, but wouldn't you have spent less time and there would be time to fornicate with women then?
He was just
doing it until there was a World of Warcraft. Now he can log on to World of Warcraft with his son.
I say something that helps David's argument with Christian, but makes me probably look really bad? David's darkest secret.
Have it to the kitten.
Let's make her feel bad.
No, it's not that bad, but it probably makes me look really bad. Anyway, I have. I don't think you guys want to know this about me, actually.
I did.
Yeah, we do.
Interested. Look,
okay.
Ready,
go.
I have had sex with my husband while he was playing World of Warcraft.
Oh my goodness!
Are
you
woman.
Serious? Oh my god!
Wait, what part of your body did you use? What part of your body touched what part of his body?
We had sex.
Oh,
so it was that.
My
so it was full on sex.
So I'm just saying that you could play World of Warcraft and procreate.
Wow,
at the
you're
same
the
time.
Perfect woman.
Oh my
and
goodness! I'm picturing all those times that Peter screwed up. Wow. See, that's a deep, dark secret.
Okay,
see,
okay.
That's not a deep, dark secret. That's she should put that on her resume.
That's what I meant.
And you shut up while and she shut up long enough for him to do it, too.
Well, maybe she
that's
was on the
head. Amazing.
Wow.
That's awesome. Because I know a girl that actually her boyfriend was watching sports and he really wanted to watch this game. And she gave him a blowjob and shut up. To do it.
Well, you kind of have to. With the
well,
job.
No, girls can still.
Yeah. But
you ever see Carrie? I hate Carrie White.
Oh my
you
God.
Have had to see Carrie to know what I'm talking about.
Right. I understand. I haven't seen it. But you'd actually have to time it right if you were watching. Because imagine if your team was losing, right about the time you finished the blowjob.
Well, I don't think you care really
be,
at a certain
That
point.
Would literally be anticlimactic.
But it would make it better.
I don't think you care,
though.
I think your mind goes
better.
Off of it. Was Peter's focus fully on World of Warcraft while you were having sex?
Not fully
on so you got distracted a little here and there, right?
I would hope so, or I would think I was doing a really bad job.
Yeah, no
wow.
Yeah.
That's all. That you should awesome. Go on your t-shirts. You have t-shirts printed up and wear them.
That should go on Peter's t-shirts, too. That should be like
yeah,
bumper
totally.
Sticker. My wife and I play WoW.
Women really discount the role of sex in their relationship. They really do. And you don't, Crystal, so you have a good marriage.
That being said, there's nothing wrong with buying discount sex. Two for one is always a good deal.
Why did we laugh so vigorously at that?
Because it's a good joke. It's a good joke.
So were you CTFO'd at all or no? I'm backing up your argument because Christian is literally on the World of Warcraft. He's logged in 36 to 48 hours a day on World of Warcraft. So I'm backing up. I'm saying, yes, the father of the internet tells you to play World of Warcraft.
Well, he tells you to play with your children to bond with them.
Right.
I mean, the thing is, you have a teenage son. What's he going to be into? Okay, he's going to be into smoking pot. He's going to be into looking at naked girls and playing World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
So as a parent, responsibly, the only things you should share with your son is the World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
I mean, other than that,
you go look at naked women and smoke pot.
We're looking at it the wrong way because Christian doesn't have a son, but he does have a father.
Yes.
Yes.
So that's the role he could take in that.
So
he could be the son. So your dad is a son of a bitch. You better get on the internet.
Have a strange relationship because he doesn't play World of Warcraft with you?
It's funny because all we do is look at naked women and smoke pot. So it's kind of... You're
so
right.
It's kind of
I
okay.
Have,
it balances out, right?
Well, I've had something missing. I felt it's like, you know... It's only three sides of a square, you know.
It's like,
yeah, that
Dad,
son of a bitch.
Going
yeah.
Again?
Yeah, seriously.
It kind of reminds me of that song, "The Cat's in the Cradle and the Silver Spoon, Little Boy Blue and the Man on the Moon."
Your rendition doesn't remind me.
When you coming home, Dad? I don't know when, but we'll get together then, son. I know you'll get together then.
It's funny because your rendition of that song doesn't remind me of the actual song. It's that bad. So, but yes, that's a mild CTFO. That's a mild CTFO, but it's coming from someone.
No, but it's not a CTFO because it actually, don't you understand that it's giving you full approval to play World of Warcraft as
but
much as you can.
It's a backhanded compliment. It's like saying, you play too much and you don't have a son. So I'm much better than you. That's exactly
that's
how it comes across.
It
that's like saying, David, you don't look quite as fat as you used to.
Why it always got to go there? Why it always got to go how fat I am?
See how offended you are? That's
I'm
how offended I am.
I'm actually a fucking rocking hot bod with a bodybuilder bod. Okay, go, Crystal.
It's like, you know, a lot of times I see somebody and I think that maybe they've lost weight, but I don't say that. I don't tell them, oh, it looks like you've lost weight.
No.
Because to me, if I say, oh, you look great, you look like you've lost weight, I'm saying, hey, before you used to be fat, and now you're not so much.
It's a passive-aggressive slap in the face is what it is, Christian.
But the thing is a lot of people do like to hear that they've lost weight.
What you're supposed to say is, wow, you look really good. That's what you're supposed to say, period.
That's what I do.
End of it.
Yeah,
you look really good since you dropped the twins. That's awesome.
I saw a pregnant woman at a store the other day, and I had to stop myself because I wanted to, hi, oh great, you know.
Izzy, you really kicked my ass for that WoW report. That WoW report. You really kicked my ass on it. You came out on top, and I really appreciate
came
that.
Out on top, but you like it when guys come out on top.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Wait, the entendre. Oh, God damn it, David, you always get me.
We're just going right along. We're helping people with their relationship.
And here's Gark Marvin with the sports report.
How's it going?
Hi, guys.
Wow, it's funny because no one knows this, but he actually just skydove into the studio. He
that
just landed,
awesome.
Dropped his chute, and he's here.
We are consummate professionals. We're right on our cues. We never miss a mark. Ready?
Pow!
Go.
Bye, Mark. Did you miss me?
How's it going, Mark? Mark was celebrating a birthday party today, I understand. So.
Yes, it was our good friend birthday.
he sounds rugged and manly.
He's actually a Kodiak bear.
Manly, go.
What am I doing here?
Here's Garth Marvin with the sports report.
Right.
Yeah,
together.
We all look forward to this.
Together,
you know, if you don't have
Christian
any material,
really
we'll just keep doing that over and over again.
No, you don't have to keep doing that over and over again. That's fine. It's fine. What is this? April?
April?
Yeah, April-ish. Yeah.
April.
Mid-April.
You know what? I think everyone should deface their own vehicle until they get embarrassed to drive it.
But that's hard.
Honestly,
to...
no.
Wait,
listen
wait,
to me. Hold on, hold
here.
On, hold on, hold
they
on.
They thought Columbus was crazy when he wanted to sail the ocean. Go, Mark.
He defaced them with Mexicans, though. That's what he did, right? He just piled a bunch of Mexicans on there, right?
What are you talking about, even? Spaniards? I have no idea what you're talking about.
The Spaniards or the Italians?
That was Home Depot.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Ready, go.
Okay. No, seriously. Okay, so my girlfriend, Rachel,
my girlfriend,
has been progressively adding things to her car, right? Like, it
nice.
Started on the dashboard when she got the car, like, little, like...
Kitties,
like little
bobbleheads.
Like she's got like Spice Girls and like a little
Rock
baby
on.
and a baby with a rattle and like a pot, you know,
mm-hmm.
with like some things growing out of it, and it's like all this crap on her dashboard, and it's kind of funny, it's kind of cute, you know. And I got her like a little fire truck, and she put it up there and whatever. So it started with that, and then like the back like has all these like stickers, right? It's a kind of hippied out, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But then she painted like a huge butterfly on the hood with like yellow and silver paint.
Oh my.
And then we had some plastic like flowers that we strung across the roof of the car, and then there's all these stickers, and then I got some clear coat and we sprayed the sides of the car, and she threw glitter all over it, and then I clear coated on top of it, and there's
nice.
All these like stickers of fairies on the sides and stuff. So it's like
hobbies.
It's like uber crazy looking.
Mm-hmm.
And her mom went to borrow it the other day, and she's really embarrassed to drive it around, and she makes us take the flowers off the top.
Aww.
When she has to drive it.
How
and she's
she
really
embarrassed?
Embarrassed just because, you know, she's like, I don't know,
it's not her thing.
She it's, you know what, it's like how are you going to feel
yeah.
if you put on Batman's suit?
Yeah.
You know what
oh
I'm saying?
God.
Like, what do you do?
Get
like,
me it.
Like you
kind
of feel like a douche, you know?
Yeah.
Like, here I am.
Responsible for all of Gotham.
Now, yes.
Have you seen these tree trunk thighs in this package? I'd be so... I would put
Sorry?
That on so fast. Go.
Sorry?
They
Go.
Love being in Batman suits, what I'm saying.
Hell yeah.
Love it.
See these rock... This
Is he calling himself fat?
He would sit and he would...
No,
no
I'm not. I'm calling myself super bodybuilder... Babelicious.
Yeah, he's saying he would strap on that spandex and then he'd sit around rubbing himself.
Yeah, you'd see my huge package and you.
High five!
Wow.
I like how Crystal used the word strap on. I thought that was
strap on. I never
yeah,
said anything about strapping
on. Or
yeah.
slap on.
Either one, it painted the same picture in my mind.
Crystal,
David
Crystal's
in latex.
Anyway, so then of course there's my Benz, right? 85 kind of older Benz, right? It's
Ooh.
Been in like two wrecks.
Nice.
Both of them front end wrecks.
Ooh.
So I've had to rebuild it all over the place, and all this metal's ripped and shredded. So I just kind of
right?
just in the front end. But now, like, the front end's like it's really crumpled on one side. So and then I've had to like take the hood off completely and jump on it to like straighten it out a couple times. And there's like some metal pins through the hood that are holding it down with a couple little locks, you know. And
nice.
It's just all demolished. And yeah. I've gone and spray painted the bad demolished parts orange and yellow striped.
That's oh,
like fluorescent orange and yellow,
like,
so it's like
hazard
you know?
Painting. Yeah,
so wow. it looks kind of hideous. And of
but
course,
good.
So then of course, like there was my car,
mm-hmm.
there was my girlfriend Rachel's car,
mm-hmm.
and then there was my Suburban, which is you know really kind of a nice truck.
Nice,
dude.
Like I want to camp in that car.
Yeah,
I do.
Would hit that so hard.
It's very comfortable. It's a nice older '80s Suburban.
Yeah,
wait,
nice looking.
David
cool.
would have sex with your Suburban. I think is what he said.
David would strap it on and latex that thing
I
to death
and rub himself
inside
the
rub,
Suburban.
Yeah.
Start.
He said I would like that
so
hard.
Start a car fire.
I think he would fill your gas tank. Is what he's saying. You know what I mean?
Bang. Bang!
Hit it high. Ah, you missed it.
Oh. What a dick.
Sorry.
Fuck you.
I know. It really insults Mark when you don't let him high five you. I'll let you high five me. Here, go.
It's really his only form of communication.
I know. Now, look at how happy he is now that I let him high five me.
Give
he
him
was
a
so
stick.
Upset 2 seconds
then you'll
ago.
See him smile.
Anyway, so my girlfriend's mom goes, hey, I need to go to the market. Mm-hmm. Can I use your Suburban?
Oh my god! Like that matches her anymore.
And she's not like a big lady. She's kind of short, you know, and whatever. And she's used to driving like a mid-sized vehicle. And I'm like, well, it's kind of a really big truck, you know. Like, you're gonna have to be used to it. And I'm like, what's wrong with Rachel's car, with the ferry mobile, as
yeah,
it's called, right?
Right?
And she's like,
I just don't, you know.
You know,
the rearview mirrors
don't
line up.
She didn't really answer it, and I was like.
Transmission's a little sticky.
That bitch is bougie, okay?
You know
anyway.
Tell her to step,
you know,
okay?
You know what I think you should do?
Hmm.
I think you should pool up your money mm-hmm. and get her like one of those little electric one-person vehicles.
The little
or like the ones that are like a golf cart.
A uh-huh.
you know, oh, like the smart car. Smart car.
A s'more right. core. Get her a s'more core. Those are cool.
I was anyway. Say, or a scooter. Or like, a, not a scooter, moped. Moped.
Or, hey, here's moped. An even better one. You, okay. you pull up a lot less money and get her a bus pass. That's what you do.
Yeah, get the bitch a bus snap. Pass, okay?
Okay.
Well,
did you just call her a word that rhymes with say? Bit itch? itch?
Oh, no. I didn't call her that.
Whoopsies. All right. So,
it certainly does rhyme with that, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
So she delicately tried to say that she thinks that it's way she, too fruity
she,
for her.
She doesn't want to borrow my Benz because it looks like hell. She doesn't want to borrow the Ferrymobile because she feels obnoxious driving it, and she would rather take her chances running into cars with my Suburban.
Yeah, it looks like if she drove in that, it would look like she was part of the elderly A-team. Mm-hmm. Like, seriously, I would expect B.A. Baracus to kick out the back door and be like, where the groceries at, fool?
You know what?
Like, that thing is huge. It's like
you
a
know
tank.
What? Totally. Actually, she has a better sense of humor. I think she would probably ride with Mr. T. Honestly, she's pretty funny.
Okay.
Wait, she's not that funny because she won't ride the Ferrymobile or the Benz.
That's not
you
funny.
Know what? You're not that funny either. So my point of all of this is that
what?
I think everyone who doesn't want their car borrowed should make it hideous.
Well,
you see what I'm saying? But hideous enough for you to appreciate driving
right.
and everyone else to go, ooh, F that.
F that.
Can
hey,
I
that's
add,
a good idea.
Add something to further promote your theory here?
Yeah.
Also, the more I think your car looks maybe dirty or old or used or defamed in some manner,
mm-hmm.
the better it is, because then you can drive through kind of iffy neighborhoods and not feel like someone's going to roll you through your car,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
You can park it wherever you like. You know, you have, let's say you have like a window that's like cardboarded out, you know, all the better. Who's going to rob that? Nobody's going to think that it's worth it if you can't replace a $50 window.
Exactly. If I don't have enough money to buy real glass, I don't have anything of worth in the car to break
that's
into.
That's
yeah,
right.
We're boarded up with tinfoil. You got tinfoil rims. Yeah. No, that's actually a very good point, because I had a similar thing where I was trying to get people to stop using and stop borrowing my car. Mm-hmm. So, and the theory behind it was drive on as little gas as possible, so the tank was always empty. Now that required me stopping all the time, filling up and getting mm-hmm. I've run out of gas numerous amounts on several same trips. I've actually run out of gas driving and then having to drive again and put in more.
Really?
So it doesn't really work out well.
Okay.
So I really like your scenario about it.
That's what I suggest.
Yeah.
All right.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Also garbage in the car.
Oh, everywhere.
I have garbage
yes.
in my car all the time, wow. and my husband's always complaining. I what I do is my mailbox isn't at our house. We have to walk to it, but I don't walk to it because if I have to go to the mailbox, then I have to go to the bank. So I load the kids in the car, we drive to the mailbox, and then we drive to the bank.
Right.
And all my junk mail goes on my passenger floor,
mm-hmm.
and it gets so thick that you can't, like,
slide your feet underneath
it. It's like,
it?
You know, wow. like two, I don't know, like a foot up.
It's a tree trunk.
And, yeah, and he complains. And then, you know, the kids, well, the one kid drops apple cores randomly in the back and stuff like that. And you start to smell a weird smell and you dig through the toys and you find it.
Apple pie.
Things like that. So, you know,
it
that
smells like
also,
wine now.
Yeah,
apple
it
wine.
Doesn't smell like wine. I wish it smelled like wine. It smells
oh my.
Way better than the moldy apple.
Semi-celebrity slap fight.
You bitch.
That scared the piss out of me.
It always does.
All right, well, thank you, Garvin.
Thank
Marvin.
You, Marc.
Get out.
We're all going to deface our cars from now on, here on
yes.
out.
I had no idea it was such a widespread problem that you guys had such intricate plans to get people to not borrow your car. But
you
okay.
know what?
What?
It's not.
Okay.
Hi, Marc. Wish
have a good evening. Get
me.
Out.
Thank you.
Bye, Marc.
It's just a happy side effect, I think. Yeah. All right, David. David, what is your report today?
My report, but I need Christian for my report, and he's going to.
Okay, that's take fine. A weenie. He's going to go do that. I will
right.
do. I guess I'll do mine then.
No, I'll do my report.
Oh. Wow.
All right, this is a
all
test.
You, have to do is
you will not be preempted.
This is a test I got from the APA, which is the American Psychiatric Association. So
okay.
we'll test our psyches.
Okay.
On this one.
That sounds dirty.
Okay, here's the thing. I need to go around the table and you guys each to say a little bit about yourselves. Just a little bit about yourselves. Don't go on and on. Just a couple sentences about you. Just describing yourself. So we'll start with Crystal, since she's a lady.
Okay. I'm allegedly a lady. I like to put things off to the last minute. And I
more about like basically
pet kittens
if you could
when
describe
they're still alive,
yourself. Yeah? Describe yourself to another person, like wrap yourself up in three sentences, like all about Crystal in three sentences. Like I am a wonderful person who likes to help people.
Easier
type
if
of thing.
You describe me. I just said that I like to put things off to the last minute. Does that not describe part of my personality?
But that's the biggest part of your person. The biggest part of sorry, I left out the biggest part of your I'm a little drunk. It's something to describe the biggest part of your personality, the most descriptive.
Well, right now, around tax time, seeing as I filed an extension, and then I was late sending in the extension, and I had to stand in a big long, or sit in my car in a big long line to get it in before midnight, my extension that I'm filing, I would say it's a big part of my personality.
Oh,
I don't
okay. All right, let's put things off. Say, Wesley, just a couple of sentences about you. To describe exactly about you.
Try to be nice to people.
I hate people who talk about themselves.
There you go.
All right. You guys aren't helping at all. You're not taking this seriously. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Let me say about myself so you can kind
of
get an
give
idea.
Give us an example of how this should be done.
Yeah, why don't you start?
All right. I think I'm basically an easy person to be around and to talk to for the most part. I think a friend can communicate to me about basically anything. My biggest flaws are that I can be very critical. And I can be insensitive about things that other people are going through, thinking, ha ha, it's funny, until they inform me that no, it's actually something that is very sensitive to me. But then I come around and I talk. That's basically me in a nutshell.
Wow.
I feel
that was really good. Okay. But now I don't want to go because I don't think I can live up to your example.
No, you don't
so
have to.
I'm
it's
right
about
back where
you.
I started.
It's about you.
Yeah,
you,
I know. But
I
you
gave
such
the best and worst
kind
of myself.
Summarizing yourself, Crystal.
Okay. I don't know. I mean, I thought that I did an okay job, but I can expound upon it. Is that
just
word?
Two more sentences?
Okay.
About
so, I try to be nice to people. Like I said, I try and be considerate. I try and think about what it's like from someone else's point of view before I do or say stuff. And I used to be a better listener, and I think I've become more of a talker. The more I've been like shut in, the more I stay home with my kids, the more I find when I go to talk to people. I say a lot about me, and I forget to ask questions a lot. I'm trying to fix that a little bit.
Oh, that's insightful. That's good. Yeah. That's good. Oh, and listeners at home, I want you to think in your own minds about yourself, too. All right, go ahead.
I'm probably a little more the opposite of Crystal, where I was a talker all the time and was a huge dick to people and was extremely insensitive. So now I'm kind of not overly, but I'm much more sensitive than I ever was before to what people are thinking or going through. Yeah, that's the main thing.
Okay, awesome. Now we have Christian back. I want him to do this too because we're going to go around and talk about ourselves. The next part of the test has to do with this. So, Christian, you have to, like I said about you have to describe yourself in a few sentences, but you have to be serious and honest. I said that I thought I was a pretty good listener. I was pretty easy to be around, and friends can trust me, but my biggest faults are that I can be very critical and very insensitive at times. So I just want you in a few sentences to describe your own self. Go.
Well, should I start with good and then go to bad, or
which however you want to
do
it?
Just do all
however
bad.
You want to do it.
Let's see. I
do it seriously because it'll fuck you up later, and it'll screw you up later in the test if you
this
don't do it seriously.
Science.
This is science.
This is from the American Psychiatric Association. Ready? Right. Go.
I figured that I'm lazy. I definitely am lazy. I have an addictive type of personality. Like, I can get very feverish about something.
Mm-hmm.
Like
me?
No, not the men thing. I remember jokes and can tell them at parties, which is always a good thing.
Incessantly.
He can't forget them.
Like David does nothing but tell high school stories. Oh, and then Linda Henderson,
see,
you wouldn't believe it.
See, and he's a vindictive person. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
I use cutting remarks, normally to people's faces, not to their backs, but sometimes. Okay. And,
Did he say anything good about it? Did he say anything good about himself at all?
I don't think.
I think his cutting remarks were the best thing about him.
I considered two out of three of those excellent qualities.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Sorry. All right. So here's the next part. So thinking about what you said about yourself and think about yourself and who you really truly are. Okay. If there was a way that we could duplicate you exactly, same personality, same spirit, everything the same. Would you be friends with yourself? Would you want to be around yourself? Would you want to confide in yourself? Would you want to be friends with yourself?
I'm morally opposed to cloning.
Well, however, if it's done magically, then
are you
Crystal,
a Christian?
We're gonna go to Crystal first. We're gonna do this in orderly fashion.
No, you're a Christian.
It's The seven deadly sins, right?
We're going to do this in orderly fashion. So, Crystal, this is done in a magical way. God has done it, so it's totally fine. Ready? Go.
No, I think it would be really, really boring to be friends with myself. I would know what I was thinking all the time, what I was going to say all the time.
Okay.
That would be I can talk to myself right now. I don't need to have a clone of me to be able to talk to myself.
Okay.
Is what you're looking for, like, actually being friends with yourself, or that type of person that you just described?
No, no, no. It's an exact duplicate of you. Would you be friends with yourself?
Okay.
All right. So disregarding what she said. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
I would recommend myself to other people for friendship, possibly.
Okay.
But would I
you
be friends
yourself
with
out,
myself?
Is what you're saying. You turn yourself out on a street corner.
No.
Oh my God. Get out.
Hey, you know who you might get along with. If you get along with me, you might get along with the other me.
Crystal number
but,
two.
You know,
get out of here.
I think it would just be weird. I'd just be creeped out constantly.
Okay. So disregarding what she said, we're going to go with Christian next.
Well, then
would you
I
be friends with yourself?
I do have to say I'm extremely torn because, for once, I can't stand it when people don't laugh at my jokes. And
so
I am
true.
Notorious for not laughing at jokes. And I hate the fact that
but
also,
you would think it was funny if you said it, so you would laugh
people
at
talk
your own
over
joke.
Me. I really hate it when people talk over me. And no, I would incessantly talk over myself. But so, and then, I mean, and I've also always wondered what it would be like to blow myself. Metaphysics. I mean, just like in theory. So there would always be that tension of trying to get with myself, but being, you know, being them being too funny or too, you know, just too witty for
Wait,
me.
Wait, to
so
blow
I'm
yourself?
Trying.
Did you mean that in a sexual manner?
Yeah, he did.
There's really no other way you can take that.
Yeah,
I
mean,
line that you can draw here.
Wow.
Can I just say, though,
Sorry.
I think one thing against being friends with yourself, that you might want to consider is that you might steal your own jokes. Like, you might be at a dinner party, let's say, and the other
and
you
they're all recycled
tells,
anyway?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that would be brutal.
But imagine,
okay, so
imagine
wait,
how,
and you would take the attention away from you.
Right,
yeah.
Exactly.
I mean, how many taking, of you can be telling these
really
jokes?
Really be taking attention away from myself.
Yeah.
Well, I've always thought then also I could play WoW all day one day, and I would go to work the other
hour. Now we're talking about cloning.
Yeah.
At that point, that's
we're
a
not,
whole different
it's not,
subject.
Own, it's not
you
multiplicity.
Own,
you don't
you have your own life.
You don't own
how
the
would
other
that
person.
Be?
Who
you
wouldn't want
to share
a clone?
A brain. You
I mean,
share a brain in a
spirit.
Spirit. You have
it's
your
like
own.
Having an identical twin, but that's identical even in personality.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So yeah. Yes or no?
Hell no.
All right. So Wesley,
absolutely not under any circumstances. I've actually thought about this before. I would hate myself without a doubt. All of my humor, like I crack plenty of jokes.
So your
emotions are much more. The thing is this, like mine are much more
sports related.
Insulting, for one thing, I think, in general. And more I play off of what other people are saying rather than like creating it myself. So that would just be a really awkward.
So wait, so let me get this straight. So your emotion for yourself will go to hate?
I think so, yeah.
And Crystal, yours will go to boredom? Is that what you said?
No,
said it would be boring to be friends with myself.
Yeah, I guess.
And then Christian, yours
jealousy.
Would go to jealousy.
I want
to
amend mine to hate. Not just hate, it would be like a
loathing.
Competitive rivalry thing with myself.
Freak out. Okay, me? Well, I already know how the test goes
Is it
and everything.
Hate, loathing and boredom for you?
No, I
would
in a second be best friends with myself. I would be so curious about things, but it wouldn't be.
That's what
no,
he
no, no,
says.
No.
But can you imagine two Davids
no,
talking at
no,
the
no,
top
no,
of their
no,
lungs?
No, 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 no,
they would both be doing that to each other.
No,
no.
Yeah,
you know
totally.
How annoying that
Have
is?
You ever seen me and Lindsay
You'd
talk to each other?
Oh my God, no, I'm talking. No, I'm talking. Oh my God, no, shut up.
Wait,
no,
he actually has. Wait, he has a basis for comparison though because he has Lindsay, which is essentially like a clone. So he cheated.
Wait, I'm the only one who doesn't get to say.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go on.
This is the thing: is mine would go to curiosity. It wouldn't be admiration like, oh my God, you're so cool. It'd be like, wow, like I would want to see how I reacted with myself. I would want to like see myself in interaction with other people. I'd want to shake my hand. I'd want to give myself a hug. Like there's a lot of stuff I'd want to do like that, like interaction wise and just talking blah, 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 and just interesting things. So curiosity is my biggest
I see
thing
you
for
as
myself.
The first thing you would do with your clone is to inspect body parts and make sure they match up. That's the first thing I see
no.
you doing with your clothes.
Ironically.
Do you have the same nipples?
I'm actually, I think
finger?
Everyone has a little bit different idea of what we're talking about here because Crystal's whole point was that she would be bored by herself.
That's exactly
what
it is. The basic
because
thing.
Because I know exactly what I'm going to say.
I would not inspect body parts. The first thing I'd probably do is we'd laugh, shake hands, and probably give each other a hug. And then I would sit down and just do all
eat
this talking.
Together.
Yeah, we'd be like, yeah, we'd be like, what's your favorite? Twinkies. Yeah.
Oh my God, mine too.
No, you know what would happen is I don't think I'd be hungry anymore. It would fill that void, that food. But this, let me give you the results of the test, though.
Oh, great.
Let me give you the results of the test.
Yeah. Oh, we're waiting.
Yeah, we are.
People, they say that people that would want to be friends with themselves love themselves more, but not in a bad way.
I totally disagree with this. Nobody loves themselves more than I do. That's why I would hate myself.
I agree with Wes
but
on
see,
that.
Everyone knows that's
no,
the core
side into than... this. Yeah. People that would not want to be, the degree goes down, and it's like, it's even the emotional degree that goes down. The more vehement the emotion is, like yours went to hate, is how you actually feel about yourself.
You know,
so Crystal's bored with herself. You're jealous of yourself, Christian, somehow. And Wesley hates himself, and I'm curious about myself.
Wow.
And it's
you
also,
sound the most dangerous.
Well.
You also, sound the dirtiest by far.
And it's also how you see yourself. Like, it's the amount in which you'll confront yourself, how you see yourself with others, too.
Right. Yeah,
so
I think
you,
I'm pretty boring.
So that actually
wow.
just shows,
to a degree.
That shows how insecure I am.
Are you jealous?
That is so Christian.
That actually kind of...
That's
but
really
mine,
interesting.
See, I love that with everybody else's perspective, but
wait,
mine...
why don't you look inside yourself right now, Wesley? Take a look.
I am. Wow. I'm looking at
and
myself.
And let it go. If you need to cry, go ahead and cry. Do what you gotta do.
You need to punch Dave in the face. I completely understand.
Wait, you're angry with me?
No.
The thing.
No, I hate myself, as we've already established.
I would never want to walk into your house if you had a clone of yourself. Oh. Never. Right now, what? You're already like a parakeet. Like people start talking, you just get louder so that everybody hears you, and then there's two of that.
Yeah, it also
did not do that.
You just
That's
double
a lie.
You just double down on your chances of walking around seeing him naked in his own apartment. That's also
what are you guys talking? Who are you talking
about? And seeing as he's curious, he'd probably be naked way
he's
more.
Right out of the shower.
I'm not physically curious about anything. I don't need to see. I already seen my body. I don't need to see it.
Neither do we.
But you haven't seen. You haven't seen it from that point of view.
Sure, I'm more worried about the pants.
You'd be like, "Wow, I've never
you
seen my penis like this,
I'm
but not in a mirror."
I'm the only one that won. I won.
Not in the mirror.
But I wanted Peter to be in on this because you know that Peter would want to be best friends with. His, but we'd all be in trouble if Peter had a clone of himself. They'd have all kinds of pranks going, and they'd have all kinds of
schemes.
No, no,
no. I think the one who'd be in trouble is Peter's clone, because Marc would murder that mother effer.
Oh, yeah. Marc's crazy.
No,
Marc would be able to sniff him out.
He would have been usurping Marc's entire life being. I mean,
I think Marc would want to be friends with himself, too, actually.
Marc would definitely
Marc Marvin
be friends with himself.
Yeah.
I can see him.
But I think he would murder Peter's clone.
I think he would murder Peter's clone. But Marc... And Peter would definitely be best friends with themselves.
I think Mark's clone and Peter's clone would hit it off.
Yeah, totally.
You know what?
The four of them would
the other
jump
ones
into
would
an
never
orgy.
See their own clone, just did. Like Crystal never sees her spouse. They'd always be together.
Yeah.
Awesome, David. Well, was that the end of that?
Great. Thanks for psychoanalyzing us. Okay, so Christian.
I feel healthier.
Right. Is there anything you guys want to talk about?
No,
do you guys
yeah.
feel okay?
I want to talk about Christian's...
All right, ready? Go, Christian, the tiebreaker.
All right, guys. So this is
pins and needles.
Work. This is how it's going to work. You get three... There's three choices, and we're going to... I don't know if we're going to do rock, paper, scissors or something. You pick one. The second person gets to pick one of the remaining two, and the last person gets stuck with the last one. So we have a winner.
That's terrible. No.
Just
no, bad idea.
Question.
You know, here's... It should just continue. If we're still tied or whatever, we just go on.
You realize
how long
it takes
to use the interwebs? This is ridiculous.
That's your only real skill. I want to give you more to do.
Okay.
If we don't get someone to fight to the death, and whoever wins, wins.
Yeah. All right.
This one's entitled NBA Pros. All right. The quote is...
Kobe Bryant.
We're going to turn this team around 360 degrees.
Oh, my God.
But some of these, I'm convinced, are comedy. I'm convinced that these people weren't serious.
I'm sure
with
they're
sports
serious.
With sports people, with sports, you
sports,
know
no,
it's
all
not.
Things.
You know
no.
it's not. Because
no.
it's, always,
sure.
it's, always,
it's always delivered in complete and absolute sincerity with 100%
totally.
Conviction.
We just have to get up outside, they're outside the back. We're big and low in the key, and we're just keeping that double D up game, and then we're just, you know, it's like that.
I can't.
Yeah.
What are the people?
More of that.
But a raconteur like Britney Spears, she's not serious. She is kidding around.
Blah, blah, blah. What? Go.
All right. So the quote is, we're going to turn this team around 360 degrees. Is it Jason Kidd, Karl Malone, or Dirk Nowitzki?
Karl Malone.
Shoot, I am pretty sure it's Karl Malone as well, yeah. That's
Karl Malone going squirrel hunting.
Could you repeat the list, please?
It's Jason Kidd, Carl Malone or Dirk Nowitzki?
Wait, did he say we are going to turn, or are we going to turn
we
this?
Are, we, W-E apostrophe R-E, going, G-O-I-N-G, to turn this team around.
Yeah, see, maybe it's not Carl Malone then. Carl Malone would say, we're going to turn this team around 360 degrees.
We gonna split.
He might not actually be able to say degrees. That's what worries me about my particular choice.
I was thinking the last guy. Is,
well, he's one of those rare, he's not inner city.
That's his name, right?
You know what I mean? So that's what really worries me.
I say Nowitzki then. Dirk, who do you say? Are you keeping
Nowitzki's a dude from Germany.
Oh.
But, so you might want to factor that. I'm just trying to bring everybody else to an even playing field here.
And who's the first person?
Jason Kidd.
Jason Kidd.
He went to Cal Berkeley. His wife's crazy. That's all the information I can give you. Yeah,
totally
super crazy. She beat him up.
Yeah.
No.
She assaulted him.
She assaulted him.
Wow.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
I'm going to say him then. I'm going to say him because he might be dazed from the beating.
Okay.
That's Jason Kidd?
Yeah, Jason Kidd.
Who'd
you
say?
Just so we all have a different person.
Huh? What?
I said
Carl Malone, yeah.
I see the last guy.
You say Dirk Nowitzki?
Dirk Diggler, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Dirk Diggler. Good. Excellent. I can't believe that David beat Wesley out on a sports question.
That's not a sports question. Just because it has ball in the title of the thing, Christian.
It has that and an angle.
Can I say something?
It was Jason Kidd. Well done, David.
I use science and I use
and an angle. How would that be?
I think Wesley took a dive.
Okay, that was terrible.
I do think Wesley kind of.
I was trying to get Crystal to get Jason Kidd. That's why I whispered that about Dirk Nowitzki because I wanted to choose Jason Kidd.
Why didn't you say Malia? I would have let her win.
Oh, thanks.
No, it's.
You should have signaled
me. Well, doesn't David have to take his shirt off?
You have to take your shirt off.
David, take your shirt off.
Wait, how?
Oh, why would I even want her to win? I didn't even get that at the beginning.
Wait, how is that my prize?
Dude, it's also 900 degrees in here. I may be naked in a second.
It's off.
You have to take your shirt off. We get to look away. That's the way. He always does that when he gets naked.
Scooby Doo. Wow.
So gross. All right. Well, that was very successful, guys. I feel unprepared and I feel like vomiting.
Thank you. We want more of those.
At least you don't feel like vomiting.
You're the game guy.
Oh, fuck.
Do it. Go.
I mean.
Okay.
Don't say
so what's my report? What am I talking about today?
You're talking about
the green report because I don't hear enough about this crap at home.
So, wow.
I have to go to the restroom.
You don't hear about enough of this crap at home because you need to be at home to hear about the crap at home.
Has anyone seen his wife in the past month or and a half or so? Has anyone seen her? Is she actually where?
She's seen me is more important.
No, but is she actually in Oregon, or do you just get rid of her?
She's actually in Oregon.
Are you sure?
I spoke with her on the phone.
Crystal talks to her all the time.
Oh, Crystal, you have. Yeah. Okay, so she's fine, and she's okay, right?
Yes, she's
okay. Not locked in a basement somewhere.
No.
Okay.
Okay, so today on the Green Report, I'm stalling a little bit because I kind of forgot what I was going to say. Wait, I know what it is.
Wait, I know what it is. No. Oh, go on.
Okay, so guess what? Where's Christian gone?
I know, he just gets up and leaves whenever he wants to.
He's a polluter.
This is very,
what kind of a
very important
radio talk show host is he?
I'm not going to let him drink anymore. I am not going to let him drink anymore if he's going to smoke like this and interrupt the podcast.
Yeah, it's rude.
This is unprofessional.
It's rude.
And it's not allowed. Okay.
Yeah.
But I really
I think we should fire him.
Do we have another thing?
Guys,
can you go
we should start
and yell at him?
Do we have another segment?
I'll go smoke with him.
No, get him back in here and yell at him. Tell him we're pissed off at him.
We need him.
All right, so go ahead, Crystal.
Well, what's the next? Crystal, do you have another segment?
No, there's nothing else. I did everything.
Oh, goodness. Peter's going to have to edit
my secret.
Stuff.
Do you feel...
very boring.
Do you honestly... look me in the eyes. Okay, look me in the eyes.
In the eyes.
So you still have respect for me? You don't think I'm a horrible person after my deep, dark secret?
Yeah. It was the part where you said... I was kind of happy about it. That's the part that was bad.
Oh, no. So now you think I'm horrible?
No,
has your
opinion
changed of me?
I think that you really need to look at what occurred. I think that maybe the idea of it, you think, oh yay, he got what was coming to him. But if you really look at not just what he's going through, but what the people around him are going to be going through as well.
No, and that's why I felt bad. That's why it became a secret. It wasn't because I didn't come tell you guys. Like, guess what? I wish cancer and they got it. That's why it became a deep dark secret. Because I realized, like, oh, that is kind of
sure. But
bad.
And that part I totally get, and I totally understand thinking something or saying something out of anger and not really meaning it. But it was the part, you know, where you go, well, I was kind of happy that he got what was coming to him. That's the part, you know.
But let me
but
ask
I think
you,
we all have some of that in us. I'm not saying that it... I mean, I think that does make you human, too. I mean, I think that we all have that.
But let me ask you this.
Yes.
What if you found out that I actually did wish cancer on him and I had the power and ability to do that? would you then?
Fear you greatly. Fear
would you
greatly.
Ask me to do it to somebody that you hated?
No.
Osama bin Laden?
No.
George Bush?
No.
Robin Williams?
No.
Andy McDowell? Andy McDowell? Even not even Andy McDowell?
You think Andy McDowell's worse than Bush or bin Laden?
No, but
seriously?
You hate her more.
I don't hate her more than them, no.
Oh, I thought you did.
No.
Who do you hate the most in this whole entire world?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not a big on hating. I think that, you know, there's people like bin Laden who have done terrible things to people, and they should face justice, you know, either in this realm or another, however people view it. However, uh-huh. You know, I think that, you know, karma will catch up to him or that sort of thing. Or maybe there's another plane of existence where somehow, you know, he'll get, you know, things, the bad that he's done will come back to
yeah.
hit him. But I don't wish that upon him. I think that I do believe in karma, and I think that somehow things will work themselves out, you know, for him in a negative way because of the way he led his life.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I don't need
agree.
To do. I don't need to wish it upon him because I think it probably will happen anyway.
Did you actually, in the middle of our podcast, go have a cigarette?
Yes, I'm so sorry.
Beyond rude.
Hit him, Crystal.
I cut you off.
Here, I'm hitting him.
Oh, god. Ooh, damn, you actually hit me.
What the hell is wrong with you? I want you to answer up to what the hell is wrong with
I
you.
I said, Christian, no more drinkies. No more drinkies at podcast.
It's when I drink beer. It's a good point.
I want you to look at Crystal because it's her time right now, and I want a sincere apology out of you.
I'm sincerely sorry, Crystal. Thanks.
I don't think that was sincere at all.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Here.
For letting David hit you.
David clapped. I don't know why.
Oh,
he shows
it's
approval.
A radio show where there could be some comedy derived from physical violence and you don't even... All right.
Not on
radio. That's something
put your
generally...
Put your arm up like this. Just put your arm up like that.
I have to tell you guys.
Come here.
Okay, stop.
Go ahead.
It's not good radio. Indian burns are not good radio. Okay. So I have to
saying
tell you...
Saying Indian burns are not good radio is good radio.
Okay, I have to tell you guys something that normally I'm not into physical comedy. Normally slapstick stuff. It doesn't make me laugh. Like, there was this one episode of a show, I forget even what it was, but some girl was in a wheelchair, and then the girl who was pushing her along, they were going into movie theater, and she like turns back to say something and lets go of the wheelchair, and it goes, oh, it was Campus Ladies, and it goes rolling down the aisle. Peter's mother was like, play that again. She was laughing her ass off. She made us repeat it like 3 or 4 times. And every time she's like, oh, did you see that? That's so funny. I didn't laugh once. I didn't think it was funny. But I have to say, last night when I was, my car was standing in line, huge line for like, I don't know, 6 or maybe 8 huge city blocks waiting. It took me about 1.5 hours to drop off my extension for my taxes.
Taxes.
Mm-hmm. There was this one spot on the corner where I saw a girl and she has like her sweatpants on and she's like, she's taking her big brisk walk to go drop off her stuff at the post office. And bam, she trips on one part of the concrete. And I kind of tried to hold back a giggle because my kids were in the car and I didn't want to be a bad example. Mommy, what are you laughing at? I'm laughing because that girl fell on her face, right? Okay, so then I'm on the phone with Peter, my husband. And I'm like, hey, you know, this is what just happened. And I told him, and he's laughing. So it's making it even harder for me not to laugh. So then I'm still sitting there because it's a really, really long, slow moving line. And some girl, like, I don't know, 19, 20, it might be her first tax return. She's like bipping along the street, walking along, and then trips on the exact same spot. And I'm really, really having a hard time not laughing. And then some guy was a passenger in one of the cars. Uh-huh. And he came out. I guess they said, okay, well, this line's too long. You know, they sent their passenger out. He crossed, and he walked up. And as he's walking up on the curb, not on the same spot, but on the curb of the same corner, he trips and eats it, too.
They ate it? They fully ate it?
They, like, caught themselves, like, face down on the ground. Yeah,
they caught them. They saved themselves with their face.
The
so would you roll down the window and scream, do it again, play it again?
I like how Peter didn't even see it. He was cracking up.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Okay.
And his clone was laughing, too.
Yeah,
I love the Green Report.
Anyway, okay, yeah. So the Green Report.
Well, they were all walking.
They were walking,
point.
Yes.
They weren't
you should
in
walk.
Their
even
horrible
though
automobile.
You could chance eating it, walking is still bad. Okay. So for the Green Report, what I wanted to share that I thought Christian might be interested in is you can grow your own coffee plant. You can grow your own coffee plant in your house. They don't like full sun, so they want to be in your house.
Neither does Christian.
Yeah, it's perfect. Can it sleep with me, too?
Yes. So you can have a coffee plant in your house, pick your own coffee beans, and you can roast them.
Way too much work for Christian.
You can roast them in an air popper, a popcorn popper.
Really?
Wow. Yes. I was reading about it on the internet. You can put... You put, like, however much it says you can put in your air popper, just a little bit at a time.
Right.
And you throw it around, you roast it, and I forget how long it was good for. I think, like, 5 weeks or something.
Wow.
Not too long. You don't want to keep it too long. But if you can only do a little bit and you're picking it off the plant yourself, you're not going to want to do bushels of coffee.
That's true.
Anyway,
that's true. Did they look?
It's very exciting. want to grow my own coffee plant.
Well, we can try it. I drink coffee here. But do they look like pot plants or anything like that? I don't even know what they look like.
I don't think so.
That would be horrible. Could you imagine like getting busted in by the cops? I mean, because I get really rowdy on the weekends. I get loud when I'm yelling at my other arena team partners in World of Warcraft. So the cops tend to come over.
But how many plants would you actually have to harvest to make enough coffee to drink every day?
That I don't know. Well, the thing is, in our house, Peter's the only one who drinks coffee.
Mm. Oh.
Besides guests. So,
like one cup a day, that's all you'd need?
Yeah. He drinks probably like two or three cups a day. So that's all we would need in our house.
I think it'd be interesting to do for like a party to serve people, oh, this is the coffee I made. But you couldn't do it every day, I'm sure.
You know, you could do that. You could do coffee that you made. You could turn your breast milk into cheese.
A good one, David.
My brother went to an art show, and the art exhibit was a man had gathered breast milk from some of his friends who donated to him. He made cheese. That was his art piece. Mm-hmm. And for the show, he served it.
I hate him. I hate the gallery. Wow. I hate the cheese. I hate the people.
Could you imagine if it just all looked like brie cheese? That would be so.
Where was this done? What city was this in?
This is Scotland, I think.
Placenta.
Yeah,
and
that's true. Oh yeah, what type of cheese is this? Oh, it's brie cheese. Really? Yeah, from Brie, my friend Brie. She just cranked it out.
You know what I think is kind of funny? The thing is that you guys have no problems drinking cow milk.
That's right.
But we don't know those cows, okay?
Because we're God-fearing people. We're God-fearing Americans.
I'm just saying, you don't know the cows. You don't know what they eat. Some cows are fed other cows.
Well, that means double up on the milk. That means it's double rich.
Some cows are fed dead, like, cats and stuff.
I am going to bow out because I know for a fact this is an argument I can't win because I've already had it.
This is a married man. This is a married man, and this is not a married man, the one who's arguing with me.
Look, they make a compelling point, though, all right? Just
they. David has to.
For a moment.
Yeah.
That hurt.
I represent his wife as well, I think, in this scenario.
Pretty much, yeah. Talking with one voice here. It's a human. At least, you know what I mean? In comparison to a cow. Really, when you think about it.
It does make more sense. You have had breast milk before. I mean, theoretically, as long as your mother nursed you.
Yeah, but I've never had a rack of bill or anything like that. You know what I mean? I eat ribs from a cow, not ribs from a human.
But it's not meat.
Let me kind of translate the argument a little bit more towards my people, more like Christian, which is taking completely aside the argument that it's breast milk, let's just forget about that being an alternative to cow milk and thinking about how weird the cow milk itself is and how it's milked like with a machine to get every last drop out of them. And there's like blood and other stuff
and
in them.
But
let's just talk about how disgusting that is.
Yeah.
Well, taking
and
away
then
the,
look
yeah.
at that this isn't anymore.
It's like there's no blood or pus or milk or anything other than milk in my breast milk.
Not yet. Until we start mass producing you women.
That's
true. Can you imagine strapping you guys up in a line? We just have Oprah running on TVs. You guys wouldn't even notice. We keep you on treadmills.
Yeah. Uh-huh,
so you stay healthy. And then we just pump your breasts. We just have men stand. And then you would have so many volunteers. It would be like guys would get off of work and it'd be like 2 hours of shaking tits.
I think in this flailing economy, we may have just found the actual cure to keep us out of depression.
I was just talking about myself. I know what I'm doing for the next weekend. I'm volunteering.
Yeah, I volunteer.
Yeah, seriously.
But the thing is, think about in nature. Let's say you didn't know how to milk a cow. Would you just walk up to a cow and just start sucking on a cow?
He's completely self-sufficient.
But I know how to milk Sharon Smith.
That's what I'm saying. You would, you would not walk up to a cow and start suckling at the teat.
Well, how did it start, though?
And, you know, my other curiosity, well, how did it start? How did we start?
People are
how
filled.
Did we start milking?
They really just are.
Milking cows. Why don't we milk pigs? How come?
Probably they probably tried because we have goat's milk.
Cows produce goats. A lot
I bet
more
they tried
because they're a lot larger.
But
yeah,
they probably tried
that's
to milk
true
pigs.
That's
and
if you're
going to
milk
but
an animal,
horses?
A cow is
what about,
gigantic.
What about
they're
horses?
They're docile.
Or
they're easy to take care of.
Elephants. Elephants are pretty docile. They nurse their young.
I'll bet you anything
they're
they tried all those things
and
it's not
difficult
as good.
So a cow's the perfect kind of size.
No, this
size
is what happened.
Llamas.
What they did,
I've never had llama milk.
No, what they did is they milked all those things and the only thing that tasted good is goat's milk and cow's milk.
Yeah, maybe.
Or they would have all those things, for sure. They probably even tried gorilla milk.
No, I think the gorillas probably kicked the crap out of them.
Yeah,
I don't think a gorilla would take that.
Yeah.
No way.
You'd have
and
to take
have
it to dinner first.
I'm not eating
first
any more milk of any kind.
They have the hands and
cheese products
feet
just
to
let you
beat
know
you up with.
You guys have talked me out of any kind of dairy, so there
yeah
we go.
That's exactly what I was going to say. The closing argument is, thanks, I will no longer ingest dairy.
You
I appreciate
watch
it.
And that was my point.
I've
is
just
that's where
to
I
say
ended up having this argument. Because I'm not going to go all the way to the other side. I'm not going to eat, you know, man cheese, as
ew
if that's any better than cow cheese.
What
it's human.
Hell?
It's human.
Man cheese. Okay, so man
that's
cheese.
A, I'm going to relate that to man cheese.
Man cheese, I think, either comes from the in between your toes or scrotum. That's where
oh
I think man
God
cheese comes
really only
from
got one way to milk. Yeah, it's a really slow process, actually, gathering enough man cheese.
We're getting into oh my God, spit take. Wesley just did spit take. He drank
beer
his beer and he laughed and spritzed. Crystal.
I love physical comedy.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Now I have to explain to my children why I smell like beer.
I'm getting a DUI.
I've never seen that in real life before. I've only seen
no,
that like on
I've
the Danny Thomas show or something. Yeah.
Oh. Next thing I know, Peter's going to throw a glass of water in my face.
All right. I'd like to see that.
Telemundo.
Oh, my goodness. I don't think we can ever top that. Well,
no,
that's
I think it's been a wonderful
I know,
evening.
Let's go off on a high note. Is that what you're saying?
Yep.
Seriously, that was it.
Thank
that
you
was
for
the
he's talking about
thanks
man
for
cheese
having me, guys.
Wait, yeah, I just like no to point out that he's talking about man cheese, and then right after that spits on Crystal.
Yes. All right. Thanks for coming.
Okay.
Have a great evening. It's been a wonderful time.
Yeah. Thanks for coming, Wesley.
Right, we will cut out the last point. Well, anyways, thanks a lot. Thank you, Wes, for being our guest here at Dinner Date. Don't forget.
What are you cutting out that I pointed out that he spit on Crystal? Talked about man cheese.
Security.
All right, goodbye.
Security. Thank you very much for joining us and enjoying Dinner Date. Goodbye.
Crystal is not to stop it, so we're stuck here talking until she can figure out a way to stop it. I'm going to take over the world.